वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स, आई वॉज डूइंग द सेकेंड चैप्टर ऑफ योर इंग्लिश ग्रामर टेक्स्ट बुक, दैट इज टाइप्स ऑफ नाउन. इन माई फर्स्ट वीडियो द पार्ट वन आई हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट वॉट इज अ नाउन. आई हैव ऑल्सो टोल्ड अबाउट वॉट आर कॉमन नाउन्स, प्रॉपर नाउन्स एंड कंपाउंड नाउन्स. सो लेट मी डू अ क्विक रिकैप. कॉमन नाउन इज द नेम ऑफ अ जनरल टाइप ऑफ पर्सन, प्लेस, थिंग, लाइक अ बॉय, टाउन, इंसेक्ट. बिकॉज वी आर नॉट specifying anything in particular, we are using it as a common, any group of things, similar kind of things. It is a name given to a group of similar kind of things, that is a common noun. But as you come to proper noun, when you give a particular name to a specific person, place or thing in particular, it is called a proper noun. Like Shyam, so Shyam is the name of a proper person. Like London, proper place. But here we were not specifying, it was common. Town can be any town, boy can be any boy, but here we are specifying, so proper. And compound was when two or more words are joined together to form a noun, then it is called a compound noun. It can be one word, like a haircut. It can be used written as in hyphens, that is son-in-law, or it can be two separate words, like in bus stop. And I've also told you that stress is on the first word generally. So these were the examples. Now let us come to the countable nouns. So what are countable? As the name suggests, countable nouns are nouns that can be counted. They have a singular and a plural form and can be used with a number. So singular means one and plural means two, can be used because car, so it is singular and its plural is cars. So it is singular means it can be counted, as in 1, 2, 3, 4 or 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th. Okay, so car, and singular form is car, like desk, desks, cup, cups, house, houses. So you can count it. Okay, so this is a any noun which can be counted is a countable noun. Then you come to the uncountable noun. Again, as the name suggests, uncountable nouns are nouns that cannot be counted. So what are the things which cannot be counted? And these are often referred to substances like paper, food, plate, or plastic, or liquid, like as in milk, oil, juice. All these are liquids, gas. Because can we count liquid? No. Can we count gases? No. So these are all uncountable nouns which cannot be counted. And these are the examples. Abstract ideas, happiness, time. Can we count happiness? For me, happiness can be just eating a cake. For you, it can be going to the moon. So we cannot count it, we cannot measure it. So this, we cannot basically count it in numbers. So then it becomes your uncountable nouns. These nouns, they do not have a plural form. Happiness, you cannot put in another S, or you cannot add IES. They don't have any plural form. But countable nouns, I told you, they had plural and the singular form. But in the uncountable, they do not have any plural form. Then you come to collective nouns. Again, collective, you have done it in your, what as the name suggests. Collective nouns are words that refer to a set or a group of people, animals or things. Staff, a group of people. Team, a group of people. Staff is employees. Crew, herd. So flock, bunch of flowers. Army of soldiers. herd of sheep, flock of birds. So when a group of people are there, we give it a name like a bouquet of flowers, a team. So all this is collective noun. We have a swarm of, more examples, a swarm of bees. Our senior team has won the match. Then you can also say our class is going for a picnic. So class is actually the students in the class. So then you can say the crowd is creating a nuisance. So crowd of whom? People. So we understand the jury is one in its opinion. Jury means the people who are judging something. The gang has 50 robbers. So a gang of robbers, a group of robbers is called a gang of robbers. So that is called a collective noun. They are considered as one. They are not divided. They are not, they are considered as one undivided whole. They are not separate. Okay, so a group of, that refers to a set or group of people, and they are considered in as one undivided whole. That is your collective noun. More in the next videos, girls. Thank you.